One day, Samba, Pradyumna, Karu, Banu, Gada and other young boys of the Yadu dynasty went to the forest to play. After playing for a long time, they became thirsty. As they searched for water, they looked inside a dry well and saw a peculiar creature. The boys were astonished to see a creature that was a lizard that looked like a hill. They felt sorry for it and tried to lift it out of the well. They tied the trapped lizard with leather thongs and then with woven ropes, but still they could not lift it out of the well. So they went to Lord Krishna and excitedly told him about the creature. The ever-gracious Supreme Lord went to the well and saw the lizard. Then, with his left hand, he easily lifted it out. Once Lord Krishna touched it, the lizard at once gave up its form and assumed a heavenly form with a beautiful golden complexion. He was adorned with wonderful ornaments, clothes and garlands.
Who are you? By your appearance, I'm quite sure you are a demigod of some sort. What past misdeeds have reduced you to this form? It seems unfortunate that you had to endure such a fate.
I am King Nriga, the son of Ikshwaku. Perhaps, Lord, you may have heard of me. My Lord, I know nothing is unknown to you. Yet, as you have asked me, I will tell you how I came to be this way.
Please go ahead, Nriga.
I have given in charity as many cows as there are grains of sand on the earth, stars in the heaven, or drops in a rain shower. The first recipients of my charity were the exalted Brahmins whose families were in need. They were young and possessed excellent characters and qualities. They were dedicated to truth, famous for their austerity, vastly learned in the Vedic scriptures, and saintly in their behavior. I gave them cows, land, gold and houses, along with horses, elephants and marriageable girls with maidservants, as well as sesame, silver, fine beds, clothing, jewels, furniture and chariots. Once a cow belonging to a certain high-class brahmana wandered away and entered my herd. Unaware of this, I gave the cow in charity to a different brahmana.
This is indeed unfortunate.
When the cow's first owner saw her being led away, he said, "She is mine." The second brahmana, who had accepted her as a gift, replied, "No, she is mine." The two brahmins continued arguing, and when they could not come to a conclusion, they came to me. One of them said, "You gave me this cow," and the other said, "But you stole her from me." Hearing this, I was bewildered. "I will give 100,000 of the best cows in exchange for this one."
This is very sad.
The present owner of the cow said, "I don't want anything in exchange for this cow," and went away. The other brahmana declared, "I don't want even 10,000 more cows," and he too went away. My Lord, the agents of Emraja, taking advantage of this opportunity, carried me to his abode. There, Yamaraja himself questioned me. I told him that I would like to suffer for my sins first, and Yamaraja asked me to go to earth. At once I fell. And while falling, I saw myself becoming a lizard. Oh Lord Krishna, as your servant, I was devoted to the brahmanas and generous to them, and I was always keen on having an audience with you. Till now, I have not forgotten my past life. Krishna, please permit me to depart to the world of the demigods. Wherever I live, may my mind always take shelter of your feet.
Granted permission to depart, King Nriga then boarded a wonderful celestial airplane. All the people present looked on.
An ordinary fire may be extinguished with water, but the fire generated from the kindling wood of a brahmana's property burns the thief's entire family down to the root. Please go ahead.
Having thus instructed the residents of Dwaraka, Lord Mukunda, purifier of all the worlds, entered his palace.